हमारे साथ एक और खास मेहमान जुड़ गई हैं, नैना लाल किदवई इस वक्त हैं हमारे साथ. शी इज पास्ट प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ फिक्की एंड चेयरपर्सन ऑफ मैक्स फाइनेंशियल. बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया आपका मैम हमारे साथ जुड़ने के लिए. देर इज दिस वन थिंग दैट आई वॉन्ट टू टॉक अबाउट. 70% ऑफ द वुमेन ऑफ द मेडिकल वर्कफोर्स दैट इज करंटली वर्किंग ऑल अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड आर वुमेन एक्चुअली राइट नाउ. लेकिन कहीं ना कहीं एक ये भी इम्प्रेशन और ये भी हमें डर लगता है कि कहीं ना कहीं इस कोविड-19 का असर जो होगा उसका सबसे बड़ा खामियाजा या असर नुकसान जिसको होगा वो भी महिलाएं होंगी, क्योंकि वो वर्कफोर्स में जब छटनी की बात आएगी तो शायद सबसे पहले उसकी गाज महिलाओं पर ही गिरे. मैम आप क्या मानती हैं इस वक्त महिलाओं के लिए जो वर्कफोर्स का हिस्सा है उनके लिए ये कितना बड़ा चैलेंज रहेगा?
आप स्टेटिस्टिक्स तो देखें जो जहां पूरी संसार में हमारे हिंदुस्तान में ही नहीं पर सब जगह कि स्टेटिस्टिक्स जो है वो जो मेल पॉपुलेशन है वो उन पर ज़्यादा असर पड़ रहा है, बुरा असर कोरोना वायरस का. तो शायद जो हमारी विमेंस वर्कफोर्स है, विमेन है, इम्यूनिटी लेवल्स टेंड टू बी हायर. पर जहाँ तक ये आप कह रहे हैं ये बहुत ही ज़रूरी है कि जो भी वर्कफोर्स में आ रहे हैं हमारे हेल्थ वर्कर्स जो हैं, नर्सेज हैं, कम्युनिटी वर्कर्स हैं, ये जो इक्विपमेंट उन्हें दिया जाए जो पीपीई जैसे इक्विपमेंट्स या ड्रेस जो पहनते हैं, मास्क जो उनको मिलते हैं, कि ये बिल्कुल ठीक रहे. और यहाँ तो आपको तो पता ही है कि शॉर्टेज तो है ही और इस पर ज़रूर ध्यान देना पड़ेगा. पर ये भी नहीं कह सकते हैं कि जो ये ट्रेंड वर्कर्स हैं, नर्सेज हैं, हमारे जो कम्युनिटी वर्कर्स हैं कि वो डर से बाहर रहें. और इतने ज़्यादा एग्जांपल्स हैं जो इतने उत्साह से जा रहे हैं, काम कर रहे हैं और दूसरे की जान बचा रहे हैं, और ये तो करना ही पड़ेगा.
नैना लाल किदवई, थैंक्स वेरी मच फॉर जॉइनिंग अस. You understand business and the economy better than most people. Does it worry you that maybe there's a kind of trade-off, or can we just say, look, this is a crisis, let's keep the economy on hold for a while, we'll bounce back? Or I mean, how far can you go in stopping, really closing down the economy?
Pranoy, only time will tell, and this debate on life versus livelihoods is one which is very hard to put a finger on when we actually kick in terms of the economy. My own belief, and it's based on no research, it's just intuitive, is that we cannot leave the economy switched off for long periods of time. And if we can, basis the courage we get from seeing that the lockdown has given us hotspots where we have to be careful, but large swaths of the country are green. Now, they may be green because we haven't tested them, and to that extent, that is a worry. Mm. But if we truly believe that they are green or even amber, are there areas that we can permit work to start? And my own view is in some industries, and you touched on the construction sector earlier, I feel very strongly that where we have construction workers, they are on site, they are being fed on site by a real estate sector, which is already half dead and dying. There's a limit to how much they can do on their front. But on the other, if you have labor that is present on site, the danger of concentration is already there. Why not put them to work and put a regimen, shut them down if they are not following the rules, but let them at least get back to work and finish building what they were building.
Right, and one other area,
a house without a roof, are not going to help us down the line.
Yeah, one other area which Professor Raghuram Rajan spoke about, there are a lot of connections between some Indian businesses and international businesses. And that could cause a huge backlash. For example, the entire banking in America is dependent on call centers in India. And it's very difficult to bank offline, online in America now, because they just say India's shut down. And there's going to be, according to him, a bit of a backlash on America, saying, look, better bring all this back to India, back to America, not keep it in India, because in a crisis they lock down. So can't even call centers and international connections of businesses somehow be kept at least limping along at 50%?
I think, Pranoy, as we turn back to essential services, and the list of essential services is growing, and I'm sure that the government is looking at this, I would like to see the ITES sector, exactly as you say, for the reasons you say, to be really one which we deem as an essential service, as indeed in the past states like West Bengal had done, and they did it at a time when buns used to be called, but this one sector was always given the focus to move for the very reasons you say. And they are largely corporate. They are in their own self-interest going to make sure that their staff don't get infected because they're going to have to shut down. So to the extent that there is a code of conduct which everybody understands, whether it's social distancing, checking, testing, and a very strict vigil, we just make sure that this happens. Let me tell you, through the entire SARS event, and I was at HSBC at the time, 50% of our back office operations for HSBC were in India, and it was terrifying. But we didn't shut down our back office operations. It was critical to keep it going. And I think it is something that we can give some focus to. Certainly where there are a lot of these centers which are not in hotspots. Of course, where they are, there's a problem. Right. And move staff nearer to these offices where possible so that critical services can be run from neighboring hotels or indeed from the premises themselves.
Very, very, very interesting suggestions. Nenalal Kidwai, thank you so much.
Thank you. Excellent.
Thank you so much for joining us on this broadcast.
Right. Thank you.